We brought this home last night after dark. And not a whole lot you can do with it, obviously, after dark, but you got to move them so that you have all the forager bees. You see a whole lot of pollen going in. So we're about to open up this bucket, which is going to take some of them off and move them into a new home. Thank you for watching MacBee Buzzin'. We're just out here on another beautiful Saturday. You can probably see all the little white flowers that are out here behind me. So that's aster, and the bees are all over that. My garden's right behind me too, and the bees are all over everything over there. So basically they're just super active on pretty much everything. But the reason that I'm back out in the bee yard today on Saturday is because you can see the hives back here. I've had a dead spot where one of my hives I lost a couple months ago, right after we did mite treatments. But I found out this week that one of my DIY bee traps or swarm traps that I had set up all the way over in Red Oak actually had bees in it this week. And they've been in there probably about 6 weeks, long enough to actually build comb. So they've settled in, it's their hive. And so what I'm actually gonna do is we're going to rehive those bees into a nuke box so that we can feed them and make sure they have the resources they need to grow. And then hopefully they'll join the rest of the bees out here foraging on all these little white flowers around me. So that's what we're gonna do. I've got my equipment to get it set up. I also, before we jump into this, decided to use my borescope today to get a sense of what the bees look like inside the bucket. I'll show you what the bucket looks like here in just a second. But I ran the scope inside just to get a sense of how big the hive is. It's not super big, so it shouldn't take too long to move over. But the comb will probably be soft and brittle, so we'll want to be very careful with it, make sure we don't harm the queen in the process, but this should be lots of fun. So you can see my station that we've got over here. So we've got the bucket of bees that we're going to rehome. Got a little bit of a platform to work from over here. And here's what you're going to see me doing during the process. So you see this, is a frame, empty frame. I took the foundation out of it and basically across the back, I ran from corner to corner rubber bands to give a little bit of a backing. So when we take the comb out, we have a place for it to rest. And then once we're actually laying the comb on there, these other rubber bands then move across to hold it in place on this other side. Now, you would think, well, what do you do with the rubber bands after? Reality is bees can chew through a lot of materials. So over time, they'll actually chew through the rubber bands, which will release them, and then the bees will take them and carry them right out the front entrance. So I've prepped up three of these frames. I don't think it'll take more than that to get this hive rehomed. So that's what I was setting up over here. The other thing I have is I'm going to put them in a nuke. So I added an extra heavily waxed frame of foundation. The purpose is to give them something else to build on. I have another one over there in case I don't need those three frames for their own comb. And then last but not least, I've got a frame feeder, which you fill with water in here. This piece pops off, but it's got a ladder system and makes it easy for the bees to go down and up, which normally I don't keep this ridge piece on, but I'm leaving it this time around because younger bees, younger hives, smaller hives can have a lot more frequency of drowning. And of course, with a smaller colony, it matters a lot more if you have some bees drown in that feeder. So that's just to protect them from themselves. So anyway, putting this in, it takes a frame space. So basically I've got room for about four frames of bees in there. once they really start to build comb and get that all filled in with the food that I give them, then we'll basically graduate them up to one of these bigger boxes, but we can't do that quite yet. That's some pretty good comb. Pretty good comb. Big piece of comb in here that I wanted to salvage first because it fell to the bottom. All right, so here's my first. I'm just gonna straighten that comb up a little, but you can see here, first one that we framed up. And the main reason that was important is so that we can give a place for these other bees to go kind of start getting situated. Main thing I'm watching for here is evidence of where the queen is located. I wouldn't normally handle it this way, but this comb is holding up pretty well. But I just wanted you to see kind of a nice shot what this comb looks like. You can tell there's barely any honey in here. It's mostly brood comb, which I'm happy to have brood, but the reality is without food, these bees wouldn't live. So that's why we're rehoming them, because then it makes it easier for us to feed them. Little piece of comb with pollen in it. You can see with some of this, they get a little creative. But here's something neat. You see right here? That's a new baby bee emerging. It's probably the biggest piece. Some young brood right there in the middle. All right, so that was the last piece we got framed in there. So we're gonna put it in. There's a hive beetle right there. Those things are a pain in the butt. Put an inner cover on here, which will force the ones that are returning to have to use that front entrance, which they had this morning to kind of orient themselves. So when the queen's in there, you'll see this sort of behavior. Even though I haven't seen her yet, I'll look for her During probably a less disruptive time after I give them a couple of weeks to get situated. But you can see this nice orderly walking in a line behavior. This is what they do when they can sense the queen's pheromones. And it it is probably one of the most fascinating and satisfying things to watch in beekeeping. Some of the bees are wanting to return to that little handle right there, which is funny. I mean, they're just triangulating based on where they left this morning and where they're returning to. And so they want to return higher up. They know they're more or less in the right spot, but they're not sure if this is their hive. So they're just trying to kind of sort things out. But they'll figure it out. The other thing I think I might do, just for good measure to help them, because bees do, like, they're creatures of habit. So how about we'll put our bucket lid right here, just in case it's an extra visual cue to them that they're in the right spot. Bit of nourishment. You can see, kind of closed up the entrance a little bit, make it a little smaller, easier to protect. But about to close this up, and that's the end of another little bee removal. Well, as far as bee relocations go, that was probably about the easiest I've ever done. It always looks a little chaotic while you're working on stuff. I mean, because you got a lot of bees in the air and you have to move comb around while you're salvaging it. But you just go in with a plan and take care of business as cleanly as you can to try and be as non-disruptive to the bees as possible. Which can be a little tricky at times because they build in some creative ways. You saw the comb on that one was particularly long, so it was a little bit taller than what a deep frame is. And so I had to trim the comb down a little bit vertically just to get it to fit. But in general, it went pretty easily. Got all the comb in there, let them keep it. They got to keep the pollen. As you saw, there was virtually no honey in it. So that made it a little bit cleaner as far as hive moves go. So because of that, that's why we actually put that frame feeder in there and put some sugar feed in for them over the next few days. That'll help them anchor themselves. They'll use that to draw comb to connect the comb that they already had to the top bar of each of those frames, and hopefully start to build up and populate that nuke. It's probably not likely that they'll get to a deep hive body before winter. It would be real surprising if they did. That queen would really have to lay into gear. They'd really have to build up a lot of comb before they could do that. And unfortunately, right now, I don't have a whole lot of extra combs that I can give them to start from. So they're kind of at their own mercies in terms of how hard they want to work. But I am giving them sugar syrup so that they can start building comb, because they need the calories to do it. And I'll need to do that pretty consistently over the next couple of weeks to give them a good fighting shot of trying to get an order before winter comes. So once again, thank you for watching Ryan McElhaney on MacBee Buzzin', and following us on our bee adventure as we grow our operation, and hopefully we'll have more honey for you soon.